A table clock with day, date, and temperature reading is what you are learning to make today. Hi everyone, this is Momin here from Mount Dynamics. I am back with another interesting video tutorial on real-time clock. Not just that, I've also made few custom designs for OLED display. Link to all these sketches will be put up in the description. Have done all the hard work for you guys. Least you could do is to subscribe to my channel. That will be really appreciated. And click on the bell icon for more such videos. So let's get started with the tutorial now. In this project, we need DS3231 RTC module, 0.96 inch OLED display, breadboard wires, half breadboard, and Arduino Nano board. This is DS3231 RTC module. The main important thing about the module is it helps to keep the time running even if there is no power supply. This is made possible as this module uses micro lithium cell. Now if I remove the connections for 20 seconds and plug it back in, still it will show us the correct time. Also it has integrated temperature sensor, that is how we are able to get the temperature readings. Now we shall connect OLED display to Arduino Nano board. The VCC will be connected to 5 volts, ground will be connected to the ground, SDA will be connected to analog pin number 4, SCK will be connected to analog pin number 5. Now we shall connect RTC module to the Arduino Nano board. The ground will be connected to the ground, the VCC will be connected to 5 volts, SDA pin will be connected to analog pin number 4 and SCL will be connected to analog pin number 5 of Arduino Nano board. Now you can see the connections have been done. Most of the wires are not visible as they are behind the OLED display module. I'll show it to you by taking off the OLED display module from the breadboard. You can now see the connections clearly. Now I shall put back the components to its place. This is a different model of a table clock. This is a model which I showed you during the intro. The components and circuit connections remain same except the breadboard, where I have used two mini breadboard instead of half breadboard. This is the code here and these are the libraries you need. This is for OLED display module, this one's for DS3231 module, and this one's for running I2C communication. I'll show you how to download the libraries now. First we'll download DS3231 library. Open the page, click on code, then click on download zip. Open Arduino IDE software, click sketch, include library, from there add zip library. Then you click on downloads, then select the one which you have just downloaded. This is how the library will be included. So now we will download the Adafruit libraries. For that go to sketch, from sketch click on include library, then click manage libraries. There you type Adafruit GFX. When you find the library, then you click install. The same way we will download Adafruit SSD1306 library. Here we are defining the object DS3231 as clock and RTC date time as DT. Here we are defining the constants, which are the pixel width and height of the OLED display. Here we are initializing the OLED device by generating display voltage of 3.3 volts internally to OLED screen. Coming to setup, clock.begin is to set up the RTC module. This function here sets up the time and date. It takes up the device time from which you are compiling the code. This function is to check whether the display is properly initialized or not. This is the string function, and this string function converts the reading to text. Example, if day is 2, then it's Tuesday. The same goes to month here. It converts the readings into the text. If the month is 7, then it will be converted to July. This function is used to add ST, ND and TH just after the date. So when it's 21st, 21, ST will appear. Here we are using the string function to add 0 before the number if the number is less than 10. In this function, the current hour and minute reading are taken and converted to hours with the leading 0 plus the semicolon and the minutes with the leading 0. Coming to loop section, which is mostly the graphical representation of OLED display. Here we are filling the backlight having a rectangle shape. This is the cursor 0,0 starting point and 128,16 is the ending point. The area is told to display white color, hence it displays yellow as this is the dual color OLED display and first 17 lines are yellow. Then the next rectangle is from the line 16 to 28 displays black, then till line 46 displays white and the rest displays black. In the first panel, the day of the week is displayed. The cursor is set to 15,1, text size is 2 and the color of the letters are black. The same way, by changing the cursor, the text size and the color, date, time and temperature are displayed. To upload the sketch, let us connect the Arduino board to PC or laptop. Before uploading the code, we have to make sure that correct board and port are selected. Once this is done, we can upload the code. The code is uploaded. Let me decrease the brightness of the light. Here you go. Now you can see the date, time and temperature displayed on OLED screen. I have few more designs to share with you. This is design 1, design 2, 3 and 4. All these designs are available in the description. So that's it for this video. If you have found this video helpful, hit a like, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do subscribe for more such videos. And for our channel updates, make sure you follow us on Instagram @MountDynamics. Thank you guys for watching the video.